This is my happy face. This is the face you make when a Nissan S14 gets added to Forza Horizon 3. I'm excited. It was confirmed. So boys, just yesterday was announced a new feature for Forza Horizon 3 called the Forzathon, where the whole point of the thing is to go in and do challenges throughout the time of Forza Horizon 3. There's going to be at least once a month, or one a month, where you can go in and unlock basically some cool prizes. So the first one's actually going to be happening or starting up October 14th, where you will be able to win, and I quote, comedy horns. So if you want to go up to your friend and just honk at them in a funny way, you can do that and annoy all of them to no end. And more importantly, the Nissan S14. Yeah, it's coming and it's confirmed. Ralph said that, who is the creative director for Forza Horizon 3. I am excited. So now you should note, when you do get Forza Horizon 3, you won't be able to go into the buy menu and buy the car. You will need to do this challenge when it comes out originally and get that car that way. Now they have already said, if you're not getting the game right away, the most popular prizes and stuff will be coming back from time to time. So say you're only getting the game at Christmas or whatever, you can go in after and they might do another challenge for the S14. Anyway, so I'm super, super excited for this Nissan S14. Just combine that, the Nissan S14, we don't know what year it is yet, if it's the Kooky edition or the Zen Key edition. I really hope it's the Kooky one because I find that one cooler, but I don't know, we'll have to see. I'm excited regardless, but we've got those wide body kits, which should make these cars incredibly cool. And I'm just super excited. I cannot wait to see what's in store for this game. This is big news. We've been asking for this car forever and it's finally in, so I'm very excited for that, but that wasn't all that was said yesterday. Yesterday, Ralph also spoke about a second challenge that's going on. That's going to be happening around the late October, October 28th, October 30th, where you can drive, I want to get this quote right, literally an incredible vehicle that's never been drivable in a Forza series. To my knowledge, there has been one car in the entirety of the Forza franchise that has not been drivable, but has been in the game. If you go all the way back to Forza Motorsport 4 on the Xbox 360, that's where you will find this car. When they were introducing the Auto Vista feature, they wanted to include a pretty cool car in that you had to unlock. I don't remember how you actually got to unlock this car, but it didn't take too long. I got it myself. I know a bunch of people who were able to unlock it, but it was not drivable. And this was the Halo Warthog. You could go into the Auto Vista and just take a look at the car in all its details. I believe it was a UNSC person who spoke to you, or Cortana, I can't remember exactly, but someone like, you know how when you go into Forza Vista now and you click on a part of the car and it like reads you off some stats and stuff like that? It did that for the Warthog, but it was like Cortana, I think, or the UNSC person. Anyways, it was super, super cool. And that was the only car, to my knowledge at least, that has not been drivable in a Forza game. And I mean, with Halo Wars 2 coming out in February, we'll have to see what happens with that. But I mean, the timing doesn't really work, so it's just a theory, keep in mind, but we'll have to see what happens. I'm just super excited for the possibility of the Halo Warthog. It's got all-wheel drive steering, so the back wheels turn as well, so you could take sharper corners. And just jumping that thing throughout the Australian Outback, I cannot wait for. Combine that with the addition of the Nissan S14 and the comedy horns to annoy all of your friends, this game is just getting better and better by the day. Also, I heard somewhere that there are now like 14 custom character presets that you can choose from. I don't know where I heard that from, but apparently it's a thing. You'll obviously have male and female drivers. I spoke all about that in the Everything You Need to Know About Forza Horizon 3's customization video. So if you want to check that out, I'll include the link in the description down below. But there's apparently going to be 14 different faces you can choose, so that's pretty cool. And Warthog! S14! Annoying horns! I'm excited. Anyways, guys, hopefully you are excited for this news as well. If you are, hit that subscribe button down below. I'm going to be playing so much Forza Horizon 3. I am so excited. I have something very cool planned coming up next week that I can't really talk about just yet. But I'm going to go, I'm going to produce a crazy vlog, and I'm going somewhere cool, and it's involving Forza. I'm excited. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe, give it a like. I will see you in the next one. Oh, I'm excited for this game. So, so excited. Oh my goodness.